Hello everybody, welcome to Kingdom of Learning. So as I promised in my previous video that I'm going to start a free online course for 15 days for class 12th. So I'm here with day 1, means today is our day 1. And before we start, I wish luck to all the students who are going to appear in their board exams of class 10th and 12th. So class 12th has very less time left now for their English exam, because actually they neglect their English. They have other subjects also. They don't get that much time. They have so many practical schedules and everything. So that's why I have decided to upload these videos, and I request all of you to watch all the 15 videos which I'll keep on uploading time to time. And these 15 videos, I can ensure you that they will definitely help you to get very good marks, and you will be able to prepare your syllabus thoroughly. So do watch them till end, because here we are going to study our English through a planned strategy. So next, first of all, I have taken this book Flamingo. Means in first few videos, we are going to cover up this whole book Flamingo. And now let us see that actually there are 8 chapters and 6 poems in this book. So we have to study all these first, and I hope 8 plus 6, it is 14. So 14 means in 7 videos we are going to cover this book. Not only this book, rather in each video I'm going to take one writing section, one topic from writing section, and some tips on how to do your reading section and how to attempt your paper fast. Everything we are going to cover up, so stay tuned till end. So now if we see in this book, the first chapter is the last lesson. So let us have a recap of the chapter, the last lesson. And this is an easy chapter. And after this, we will discuss about the second poem. Means I am not going to take the first poem, that is My Mother at 66. Rather, I am going to take the second poem, An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum. Because I have planned in this way only, that one easy chapter and one difficult chapter or poem, anything. And in the same way, we will take up the writing section. So today's video is going to teach us two chapters. Means first chapter, the last lesson. Then the poem, second poem, My Elementary School Classroom in a Slum. And from writing section, we are going to take notice writing. And then at last, some tips. So now let us see the last lesson. That is written by Alphonse Daudet. And actually, this chapter is very meaningful, because it is telling us the story of a French teacher, Mr. M. Hamel, who had been working as a teacher, as a French teacher in a school in the districts of Alsace and Lorraine. And suddenly one day orders come from Germany that from next day onwards that French language won't be taught in the country of France. Means just imagine that they are living in France, but their language won't be taught in their country. So that shocking news is told to the readers through France. France is another character in this story. He is just a school going boy, and when the chapter opens up, France is going to his school, and on the way in the market, he finds that so many people are gathered near the bulletin board. Bulletin board means that that is a notice board. And he finds that so many people are gathered over there. But he does not bother to stay there, because he knows that all the negative news, all the bad news comes from that notice board only. So he ignores it. So actually Franz was very nervous. He did not want to go to school, and because he was already late. Another reason was that that day his teacher Mr. M. Hamel had to give them a test of participles, and Franz was not prepared at all. So he was just not willing to go to school, but he had to go to school. But as soon as he reached the school, he was shocked to see that the school was looking like a Sunday morning. means there was no noise at all. Earlier the school used to have so much noise, so much hustle and bustle was there, but that day it was quiet as a Sunday morning. So when he entered the class, he was expecting that he would be scolded by the teacher, but to his surprise, the teacher did not scold him. Rather, Mr. M. Hamel very politely asked him to sit there in the class. Then Franz observed that in the class, all the elders of the village were also there. They all were reading from the primers, and some of them were crying also. Some of them were, it means everybody was looking very sad. So all these things were very surprising for Franz. Then finally, Mr. M. Hamel announced in the class that that day was going to be the last lesson of his career. Means that was the last lesson in that school for Mr. M. Hamel, because orders had come that from the next day onwards, in the districts of Alsace and Lorraine, French language won't be taught. So now this news came as a thunderstruck for Franz. He was shocked. How was it possible that people in their own country, they were not allowed to study their language? And then he felt so regretful that he had never paid any attention to his language. And there were so many villagers in those districts, those who didn't even know how to write their name in French language. So now everybody was regretful. So then Mr. M. Hamel wrote on the board, "Long live Franz, vive la France," and all these things. And in this way, this chapter came to an end, leaving a very strong message that we should never neglect anything. We should never wait for tomorrow, because we never know what will that tomorrow bring for us. So at this point, this chapter comes to an end. So one thing I want to tell here, that if you want to thoroughly prepare the chapter, you must give it a reading from your book. Then it will be clearly, easily understood by all of you. So now next is an elementary school classroom in a slum. Now that poem, that is a long poem written by Stephen Spender. I have already made one video on this poem. In that means a detailed explanation is given. I'll provide the link in the description box. You have to check that definitely. And today we will do this poem very briefly in this video. And you can see that in elementary school classroom in a slum, definitely it is telling us about a particular school that is in the elementary school of a slum area. And in this poem, the writer, means the poet, is telling us that far, far from the waves, gusty waves, these children's faces. Actually, the poem is teaching us, telling us about the plight of the children who are sitting in that slum school. Means the first of all, the poet tells us about the interior of that classroom, that the classroom has very dirty walls. They are just, you can say, very dim walls, and there is no light, no proper, means the walls are not even clean. And the pictures which are pasted on those walls, they are also very useless for these children. Like the picture of Shakespeare is there, then so many institutions are there. It means all these pictures are actually useless for these children, and they should not be there. And then at last the poet is making a request to the all the high authority people that they should make some changes in the lives of these slum children. Otherwise they will protest, they will go out, they will break the windows, they can do anything. So actually through this poem, the poet is trying to spread some awareness among the people of the world that some attention should be paid towards these poor children who are studying in these slum classrooms. So if you want to see the literary devices used in this poem, and each and every word, explanation, meanings of all the difficult words, everything is given in that video that I have already uploaded, and you have to check that, and it will hardly take some time. So this time is very precious for all of you, so do check that video also. So next is third part of the video is that today we are going to do notice writing. So notice writing will be asked in your short writing skills, and that will be of 4 marks. And that will be given in your paper with optional question. Means in other option there may be some advertisement, poster or invitations or replies. So out of these 4 options, notice writing is the easiest one because children have been doing it since long. Means I think you have been doing it since your 6th standard. So it is quite easy. So first of all, you have to see the format of the notice. Then I'll tell you what are the points to be kept in mind while writing a notice. For notice writing also, I have uploaded another video. So that link will also be provided, that you need to check definitely. Their format and everything is explained in detail. So first of all, you have to write the name of the institution. Under that, you have to write the word notice in capital letters. Then in the means next line, you don't have to leave any line in the format of notice writing. Left side, you have to write the date. Then fourth line, in the center of the page, you have to write the heading or the topic of the notice. And then you have to start your content from the very next line. That is the fifth line. This is hereby to inform all that, the this and that, whatever. So in the content of the notice, you have to tell 3 things. What is going to happen, where it is going to happen, and when it is going to happen. What, when, and where. These 3 things you have to tell. And at last, you have to write, for more information, contact the undersigned. And then on the left side, at last, you have to write your signature, name, and your designation. Here you, I can give you one tip, that in notice writing, at last, generally students get confused that whether they have to write the name or the signature first. So here you can follow SNAP rule. SNAP rule means signature, name, and position. So SNAP means first of all you have to write your signature, then you have to write your name, and then you have to and position at last. Designation, that is called. So in this way you can complete your notice writing. Now some points are there, that in notice you don't have to use first person. You have to always write the notice in third person. You don't have to use like some personal details. Unnecessary details are not to be given in the notice writing. So now we have covered up 3 topics in a, you can say, very fast manner, but I think that will be clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can watch the video again. So first we have learnt the chapter, the last lesson. Then we saw what is the poem in elementary school classroom in a slum about. Then we have done notice writing also. So now I think you will do practice of all these 3 topics. Means you have to do questions from both the chapters and practice from notice writing also. Now I am going to give you one tip for your reading section. Tip for your reading section is that sometimes it happens that you do not know some meanings. Means when you are reading the passages for long, means note making and comprehension, it happens that you don't understand the meaning of certain words. So the important tip is, don't just keep waiting to know the meaning of those words, because nobody is going to tell you in your exam. So best way is to just skip those words, or you can guess the meaning. Means you read that line once, twice, and then just guess ki what can be the proper meaning of this particular word and move on to the next line. So that is a golden tip, because it will save lot of time, because your paper is going to be very lengthy. So I hope you must have liked this video and it is gonna be helpful to all of you. So please do share it with maximum number of students of class 12th if you are their real friends. And do subscribe to my channel also. So thank you for watching.